I think today, children, I shall tell you the story of Pogo. Are you listening,
Pogo? Pogo.
Are you listening? Pogo was a very bad dog. Pogo went to the Waitapu and he ate all the sacred food. Now, who do you suppose saw Pogo eat the sacred food?
Uinuku!
That's right. The god Uinuku saw Pogo eat the sacred food, and it made him so mad he went over to Pogo and he swallowed him in one big bite. Now, Pogo was Tama and Waka's doggy, and they loved him very much, but they couldn't find him anyplace. They looked all that day and all that night and all the next day. They walked for miles and miles and miles from paw to paw to paw. But no Pogo. Until one morning, they came to the house of... Right. Tom and Waka walked in and they said to Uinuku, "Have you seen our dog Pogo?
No.
Have you seen our dog Pogo?" And Uinuku said, No, I've not seen your dog Pogo. But he was lying. Tom and Waka felt so sad that they walked outside and they sat down on the ground and they went, "Ow! Ow! Ow! And Pogo, inside of Uinuku's big fat stomach, heard them and he answered. So Tom and Waka knew he was in there. And you know what they did?
No!
They went to the woodshed and they got a big axe and they cut Uinuku in half. And out jumped Pogo and he was so happy he licked all their faces. What happened to Uinuku after he was cut in half? Tama and Waka borrowed a sewing machine. And they sewed together the two halves of Uinuku again. And he was just as good as ever, only they had sewed him on backwards. And that's how he walked around for the rest of his life, backwards. Now make your canoe, girls.
Just dropped by to return this little book.
Oh, yes. Did you find it...
Yes.
Interesting?
Frightfully. Oh. All right, I'll have a try. My father is in jail. My mother has no money to get him out. She cried all night long. Now, which of you children has a father in jail?
They're just exaggerating. They're only jealous.
My father came out of jail. He cut my mother with a... Now, which of you children can read this monstrous word?
Children, children. Mr. Abercrombie, teaching is emotional. And why shouldn't it be? Knife, jail, cut, kill. They learn those words four times faster than any other words. They learn to read because they feel. Look at these books. Just look at these books. These silly, respectable, hoity-toity books. I am Tom. I have fun. My sister Anne has fun. We have fun. Fun, fun, fun. How I hate that word, fun. Where are the tears, Mr. Abercrombie? Where are the tears? There are no tears in this silly book. Why, sometimes this classroom is so flooded with tears, I have to swim my way out. My children come from a Maori village, and I want to bridge the gap between their parents and these four walls of a box with a leaky roof called a Western education. Tears, Mr. Abercrombie, must not be disallowed. I think you've probably never wept in all your life anyway.
I try not to. If I feel any emotion coming on, I write a report. Nothing is possible, you know, without a report. Excuse me.